one of the, when we talk about health, the World Health Organization, and I'm not, I don't agree with everything that they have done, but you know, none of us are black and white. We have shades of gray. We don't always get everything right in our own lives. Okay, so you should look at the whole picture and look at the net effect of a person or an institution on society. But I love their definition of health, which is a state of complete mental, physical, and social well-being, not merely the absence of disease and infirmity. So we talk about health. If we understand that definition, we can then branch off into the root causes. Because what does social well-being actually mean? It doesn't. Social well-being is not going to be improved by giving people pills. It's about understanding the conditions in which people work and grow, about relationships even. You know, most stress, for example, comes usually from either work or relationships.
Yeah.
So let's all think about that, right? What, even relationships with our partners, with our friends. These are improving those and thinking how we can improve those, and even doing a job that you enjoy, that you're good at, and that gives back to society is going to give you more fulfillment than anything else. And many people aren't doing that because we've lost, I think, the culture in many ways in society has been influenced by these very powerful entities. We may not be aware of it, but these very powerful entities that are anti-human in the way that they carry out their business. It's extracting money through deceit and lying and whatever else. And if they have so much power and control over our lives, some of that is going to seep into the culture of people.
Yeah.
So let's just go back to thinking about what does it mean to be human, but also acting from a position of values, you know, honesty, integrity, and courage. We need courage as well. We need to stand up and speak the truth, because if we don't, not speaking the truth is going to cause us more harm in the long term.
I couldn't agree more. And you're totally, absolutely right. Health is more than just the absence of disease. Just because we've got somebody that doesn't have a physical illness in front of them, they could still be leading a really poor quality of life, not be happy, not be getting fulfillment. And, you know, sometimes we were actually filming a consultation recently, and really interesting guy, middle-aged, pre-diabetic, kind of being told, look, you're going down the route of potential heart disease. You know, got lots of problems with his relationships at home, not happy with his job. And the first thing I said to him was, look, how fulfilled are you in your current life at the moment? And he just said, I actually got no purpose. I go to a job I don't enjoy. I've got problems at home that aren't being addressed. I'm not happy. I've got these insecurities, etc. So we really just actually focused on, okay, let's look at this together. How can we address this? How can I support you with this? And he came in for a follow-up, and we gave him some other dietary recommendations around his blood sugars, of course, etc. And a lot of stuff you've been talking about. And he was literally a different person. I mean, you could just see it. As soon as he came in, looked a totally different person. And a lot of that was just basic stuff that you've just been talking about, going back to the basics of what it means to be human. And I think that's what we have a responsibility to do, that for our friends and our family, and to help people be compassionate to each other, listen to other people's problems. How can we support them together rather than, like you said, focusing in, zooming in on just ourselves?
Absolutely. And I think that's crucial, because you can improve your own lifestyle very easily, but we don't live in cocoons. And even if we help ourselves and do something and get better, which is great, that then needs to be disseminated to people around us. And again, if people around us are suffering, we're going to suffer as well. So we have to think things, I think, more from a collective perspective rather than an individual one. And if we think collectively, we're helping ourselves individually as well.
Yeah.
Rather than focusing on the individual and ignoring the collective.
Exactly.